Good morning, everyone. This is Milan Desai from Easy Data Munch, and I'm the head of solutions and sales for Easy Data Munch, and we work with many customers and many finance teams, and we always get questions around how we can leverage data from a compliance perspective and audit perspective. We just thought that this might be the best opportunity for us to talk about various areas within the organization where you can use data in an automated way to allow you to do more analysis and understanding of what's going on within a specific process using data, and that will help you to see whether the processes are compliant, whether people are not abusing the system, and so on and so forth. So we have various solutions designed around some of these use cases, and we'll just walk through that. Just to give a brief background about T&E process, we are looking at trial expense reports being submitted by employees, either manually or through any system that you may be using, like Concur or any other trial expense management system. And we are looking at employees submitting the reports and receipts, and then somebody is manually in the AP team or is looking at these reports and matching the receipts and looking at all your policies and making sure that employees are compliant with the policies. And you can have policies around when you book your flights or etiquettes, when you book your travel, to where you can stay and which hotels you can stay. If you're traveling to New York, you can spend this much money. If you're traveling to some other location, you can. So there are plethoras of policies and rules and guidelines that typically an organization may have when it comes to travel and entertainment expense. And the foremost is you're looking for making sure that employees are spending money on genuine business purpose of their business travels and needs, as opposed to charging personal expenses to business. So I think that these are some of the things that we are looking for: anomalies in data sets, employees who are reporting their expenses and how they're reporting, and so on and so forth. So some of the things that questions that we get asked is, you know, what my employees are spending on, which categories they're spending a lot of money, which suppliers or which hotels, which companies they're working with, where are my employees, are they getting the right services or goods? Are there any policy violations? If they are, who are the worst offenders? How many times they do it? What's the dollar spend? And which department's budget? Can I go back and negotiate new rates or contracts? So there are a lot of things that can be done to analyze the data on child expense and entertainment category. And since one of the biggest indirect spend in any organization, we have seen that child expense can be a make or break situation when it comes to financial reporting and profits for an organization, where you can actually turn red if you don't control this expense well. So let's go to what are the things that we can the challenges that we have seen in many organizations, that there is no single source of data when you're trying to analyze child expense, and that's why it remains a largely a manual process in most of the organization in terms of audit and compliance, because you have data, employee data sitting in your ERP systems, you have child expense report data sitting in your child expense reporting applications, then you have data, e-card data or credit card data spend. If you have e-card or programs in your organization, the data is coming from your bank, and then you have a travel agency. If you're using travel agency, then the data is coming from travel agency system, and you're looking at your contract data with hotels, with airlines, with other suppliers that you may have. Your policy data may be probably sitting in some manual or book instead of being put down in a specific application which can do a rules engine-based matching. So there are a lot of those challenges that a typical organization may have in terms of just getting the data sources together. And once you get the data sources together, what kind of KPIs, what kind of measurements you want to look at, what are the compliance areas you're looking for, I think that's the next step. And also making sure that you can look at this data from the perspective of if it's an entertainment spend or a travel spend, cycle times of report, whether employees are submitting on time, whether you have employees who are traveling and not submitting the reports for 60 days, 90 days, and that it impacts your accrual process, that impacts your payment process, compliance process from that perspective. Most of the time, we have seen, again, traditional problems with T&E analysis is, again, too slow because it's largely manual and there's a lot of effort required to get all the data sources, as you say. A lot of times, employees, though they are using a travel expense management system or something like that, they may have, they really do not use it to the fullest potential of those applications. So the data may not be right, it may not be categorized correctly, and things like that. We have seen a lot of over-reliance on vendor or the travel expense application vendor like Concur. We are seeing that a lot of companies just rely on that data source, and we have seen a lot of times those data are not, the application is not correctly mapped to what organization is really doing or how the organization structure is being set. And this structure keeps changing. So again, if you're not keeping in the pace of the structure change within the support a travel expense management system, then you're not going to really see the right kind of data. What Easy Data wants, what we have done basically is we are a company which have built platforms or what we call is apps, analytics apps or templates, which basically allows business users or AP analysts or AP managers, HR managers, and finance department in particular to look at data quickly, comprehensive analysis across the organization, and you can look at all your KPIs, all your measurements without really doing any sort of development or use of IT resources or even third-party resources to give you this kind of analysis. So that's really the core of what we do today. What are the typical things that, again, we can come back to this slide. It's more about how we are more in line with what business users expect compared to what we have seen from other applications out there who provide these kind of compliance and audit analysis and reporting from team perspective. What are typical integration points? As I was alluding earlier in my discussion, that there are so many data points that you can bring in to analyze the data here. You're looking at Concur or any other travel expense application data that you may have, employee, your GL masters, your locations where, or departments, or other events that you may have, so specific conferences that your salespeople are going for or you are hosting, and then how those events are linked to the expenses that are being reported. Travel agency, that's one of the biggest areas we've seen that there's a lot of data that is being generated by travel agency. You may not have access to a lot of the data, so how do you get access to the data to see the compliance and audit? Because one of the biggest savings factor or one of the biggest compliance issues that we have come across with the organization that we have worked on is the travel data, because you may have employees that they're booking their flight tickets, they're booking their travel, and then they may have to cancel their travel, they may have to change their plans. And a lot of these data is not really coming back to the organization, which is basically housed within travel agency data sets. And unless you have access to this data, you are never going to see the whole picture. In fact, we are seeing organizations losing millions of dollars by not having access to this data. So that's one of the single factor we have seen. And we worked with a couple of customers who were able to understand, analyze this data, and we're able to save $2 to $3 million in a span of 60 days by just looking at unutilized air travel tickets that they have. We are looking at contract data from your contract management system with hotels and airlines and other preferred vendors that you may have. If you are using Salesforce, so we bring in data about your customer data and your salesperson's data. So, for example, I'm a sales employee and I'm traveling to Seattle, but from your Salesforce data, I really do not have any customer in Seattle. So that is a red flag itself that, okay, you traveled somewhere and you said that you met somebody in Seattle or a customer, but, your Salesforce data doesn't really tell you. whether there is a customer in Seattle. So those are the kind of audits and checks and balances that you can really do using this data set, as opposed to trying to manually figure out, because if you can see a report, but that is not really going to tell you whether Sam traveled to Seattle and he met this customer, had a dinner, and he spent $2,000. But, you know, in fact, he might have just gone to meet his girlfriend. So that's really the point here that we are trying to address. Application is pretty, most of the dashboard that we have configurable, business users and audit team and compliance team or accounting team can, finance team can really see what they want to see. You can look at dashboard based on your specific needs, so you can configure those dashboards, those charts and layouts based on what you really want to see as a user, as opposed to giving you a standard cookie cutter application. Comparative analysis, I think that's one of the biggest things that we see that allows you to look at different data sets within a single screen, so you can actually correlate the data. We also do trend analysis, so actual versus budgets, which is very important from finance perspective to see whether your spend is within the control or not. Supplier performance scorecards, so whether it's an airline, whether the employees are booking the travel tickets in time, and there is the lowest cost fare and all that kind of information. Water and predictive, and that's one of the areas that we excel, where we can actually build a kind of a fraud model or a forecast model and actually come back and say, this is what we predict in terms of either the cost that you're spending or how you're spending, which are the contracts that you can renegotiate and things like that. So let's jump directly now into application so that we can quickly show you how it works. So this is our application. This is an application which is a standard application that we have. But as I mentioned before, you can customize this application, configure this application based on your specific needs. Just to give you perspective here, we are getting data in this application from various sources, as I just mentioned earlier. So you're looking at this information from finance perspective in terms of just the category spend management perspective. So what's my budget? What did I spend last year versus what did I spend this year? And which month, which quarter, so and so forth, which departments, which locations, which employees, what's my spend category? We auto-categorize your spend. If it's not really coming out from the system, we actually categorize your spend into different categories, like, as you can see here, airfare, hotel, taxes, services, school, and things like that. We also provide you payment status, so in terms of if you are using a P-card program or a corporate credit card programs, or you have people employees spending on cash or personal credit cards, we also provide you that information. So the complete cycle reporting times in terms of if you, let's say, have a policy that every employee should submit the reports within 30 days, and then you need to make sure that the approval of that report has to happen within the next 7 business days, and then the payment of the expense report has to happen in the next 7 to 10 days, we can actually analyze that information and provide you that kind of cycle report time, so see whether you are within your benchmarks or not. So as you can see here, this is more like a dashboard. Again, this is all configurable, so when you want to say that I want to look at the information this way or I want to look at some other information, you can analyze this information in a specific way. You can drill down. You can select any specific quarter. So I want to select 2015 and I want to select Q3, for example. As you can see, the application is automatically showing and hiding certain filters here. So the moment I select Q3, only 3 months, July, August, and September, if you're following the calendar year, they are being highlighted in white and the rest of the months are grayed out. So that's basically the system automatically does for that. So you do not have to really remember. That's just a simple example here. But when you go to the next screen, I'll show you how it is more effective when you're looking at multiple filters that you want to apply on your data set. Now you're looking at this information at a holistic perspective. The other thing that you can do, you can export this data still in Excel so that you are not losing your Excel at any given point of time. You can also change this chart or data into table to chart or something like that. So if you're looking at information in tabular format or in the chart format, you can change that. So you can also print out this information if you want to send this out, print it out. You can send it as a PDF file if you want to send it as a PDF file. We also have an option where you can send out email alerts. So as you can see here, that expenses for this quarter were 113%, so they were more than the benchmark that you have. And basically, you want to go out and see whether you can send out an email alert to a specific department or a business head saying that, hey, why your expenses are so high this month compared to the budgets or last month that you have. Let's go to the KPI tab now and clear out my filters. So whatever filters that you had created on dashboard, as you can see, those filters have continued on every single report that you want to see. Now, if you want to clear out those filters, you can just clear out all those filters by clearing it out. That way, all the information that you cleared out is already there. We also have several other filters that you can look at here. So we have filters like booking channels. So if you're using multiple travel agencies like Orbitz, Expedia, Carlson & Weggett, or any other travel agencies that you might be or Destin might be using, you can look at the information by the travel agents. You can look at by ticket class, so different ticket classes that you may airline that has to offer, first class, business class, economy class. You can use, I want to look at only airfare. Now, the good thing about it is once you click on this, you can just start typing. It's like a Google-like a feature. You can just start typing, and it's going to show you all the airfare expenses or categories that you have, and you can just select that, and it's going to show you all our airfare-related expenses. So the data is now filtered for from that perspective. You can also look at expense types. So now we're looking at different expense types. So we selected airfare. That's what's going to show you that. But we can also let's go back and we can undo that, and we can look at different expense type if that is what you're looking. Let's say you want to look at hotel. Just start typing hotel, and you can look at hotel room rate and other charges, and that's what you're looking at. So it's pretty intuitive in terms of using this application that we have built. It covers majority of your audit and risk compliance letter. So let's go to the violation section quickly, and then I'll show you what we have there. You can also look at payment types. You can look at by companies or departments or program or events and other categories that you may have. So just looking at information here and analytics that you can run, there's a lot of information. So like report submitted, report assigned but not submitted. So all those policy violations you're looking at, all the offenders that you're looking at, what is the expense amount, total number of reports for this employee. Unassigned transaction, basically reports are there or data is there in your reporting application, but the reports have not been submitted, or reports have been 60 days, not approved in time. So there is a lot of this information, and all this is configurable. So when you say 30 days for your organization, maybe 15 days or 45 days, you just have to change, you just set that out in your configuration sheet, and system will automatically recalculate that, and again, anytime. So as a business users, you always have an opportunity to just go and change your configuration sheet, which can be an Excel sheet or an application within our system, and then you just update that, and the system will automatically refresh the data and calculate everything again. You're looking at personal expenses there, which system will identify based on predictive analytics and some of the other trend that we analyze. We're looking at specific type of contributions. The contribution amount, this is again a this is a tax deductible expense that has been spent, but it's been coming as a child expense report. So this is something that, again, it shows you that you can leverage this contribution amount for your tax write-offs or charitable contributions. Unutilized air tickets, I wanted to show you this. This is one of the biggest areas I mentioned earlier where we have seen businesses really lose out money. So you can look at here what is the issue here of the tickets, unused amount, unused count of those tickets, loss amount. So we are already calculating that the tickets have expired now, so there's no issue. And so either the tickets have expired or you do not have that employee anymore with you. Now, there are a lot of, if you have a preferred airline contracts, a lot of these airlines will allow you to reissue these tickets within 90 days of expiry, so you can negotiate those contracts whereby you can still use these tickets even post-expiry or change if the employee has left your organization within the first 90 days. So there are some of those things you can look at. Now, you're also looking at agent-assisted booking. This is typically from travel agency or desk that you're using. So since there is a cost for every agent-assisted booking, you want to push your employees to do more online or use your existing systems. This also shows you those kind of instances where you're looking at how many agent-assisted bookings were made and counts and how many were online, and typically if you have a benchmark or a ratio. So a lot of that information, bookings less than 7 days, typically frowned upon by a lot of organizations because you'll end up spending more money on travel, airfare, and expense and things like that. So if you have a policy that a business expense have to be, travel has to be booked at least 14 days in advance, then these are your violations here. Weakness of the data by clicking on a specific year. So I'm looking at 2015 and I'm looking breaking that down. I'm looking at the employee and then what expense is that. So these are the number of violations and other information that you can see here. So now you can you can look at the number of violations, and you can click on number of violations and see which employee has the maximum number of violations. Though the amount of expense can be small, the number of violations high. So there are a lot of these kind of situations, and this is where, again, as an auditor, as a compliance person or from a finance department, you are going to go to that employee or his manager and basically say that this employee is nearly not utilizing, but he's canceling tickets and not utilizing, so no, you don't know what's going on. And there can be a case where somebody is misusing the system. We also calculate different violations, as I was alluding earlier. So we are looking at a number of violations. So you have 16,000 violations in the period, and I can, again, we can go back and look at, show me the violation, more violations current year, and you have 8,000 violations now. What kind of violations are they, you know? And then you can also look at whether it's a hotel policy violation or a car policy violation. And we support very comprehensive policy violations. If you have very comprehensive car policies, like you can take the car only if, and there are different kinds of car policies you can have. You can have a rental car policy, and you can have car service, which is more like a limousine kind of a service where somebody can use that. Or people are using Uber and a lot of other things nowadays. So again, looking at what kind of contracts you're going to have, you can analyze that information pretty much. Hotel policy violation, this is based on the grade or the level of the employee, whether he's a vice president, senior vice president, or he's a sales manager, and where he's traveling and how many nights he's staying, what kind of contracts he may have, what are the preferred hotels, and so on and so forth. So there can be different kinds of violations that you can have. Air travel, which is, again, we are looking at business class, so somebody's traveling business class when he's not supposed to do, and somebody's not traveling by preferred airline. So let's say you have a contract with Delta and Southwest, but somebody is traveled by United Airlines. So why somebody has traveled unless the fare that he was getting at that time was lower than the preferred airline, then that's fine. So a lot of times we have seen those kind of policy violations where you're allowed to travel by non-preferred carrier only if the airfare is lower than the preferred carrier, something like that. So we can look at those violations as well and go back to those violators. So the point is that the system is doing a lot of this work on its own without you really manually spending time in figuring out what's going on. And then apart from that, you can still analyze this data at a granular level. You can drill down, you can click on an expense, and you can further drill down on with how it's spent. It's spent by corporate credit card, it's spent by cash, it's spent by, and then when you select, as you can see here, system is highlighting those specific selections, and based on that, it will tell you how many employees are spending that kind of money on corporate card. So you don't have to remember whether this employee is on a corporate card program or not. In fact, you can go back and say, I'll show me all the employees who are not on corporate card program, who are spending cash, and I would like to see whether I can bring them on a corporate card program. Why they are not? Why these employees are not using? So all these three employees are actually not using the corporate card, but the rest of them, which are grayed out, are using all your corporate card. So this is an easy way for you to go back and improve your compliance and your audit process. We're looking at reports here. So this is a cycle time. So when the reports are submitted, when the claims are submitted, what's your typical time? So you're looking at your target is 15 days. Are you within the target or not? Looks like you are within the target here. Your target to average submission days after the report is being approved is 7 days, and 5 days, and you're looking at 3 days. So whether you are paying the report or cumulative, it should be 15 days, and you are a little bit out here. And whether when you are paying, how you are paying, are you paying in different currencies? So if your employees outside United States, so you're looking at paying in different currencies, different currency conversion rates can be applied here. So we actually show you this amount based on the currency conversion that you want. Let's say we can go and take your daily rates from the markets and bring you that conversion, or we can provide as a conversion rate card, which the system will automatically calculate. Let me show you quickly. I want to export this report in Excel. I'm just going to click on it, Excel, and it's going to bring that Excel. So I can just now open this Excel report, and as you can see, it's a pretty much formatted report. So you really do not have to do any reformatting of reports when you download the data in Excel. So that's an advantage that our system brings in. And as I said, you can also do PDF, you can do print and PDF, and a lot of those options are there. If you want to see this information in a table form, it can quickly change from chart to table. You can quickly convert back to chart. So again, there's a lot of these kind of smart options that are available within the system. Outstanding cash advances. I think that this is one of the, again, big audit and compliance issues that we know most of the organizations would like to look at. So if you have given advances, cash advances to employees for their travel, then you're looking at whether these are outstanding. So, you know, you want to make sure that employees, when they take in advance, they travel, they submit the reports in time, so you can take in account for all these advances. These are some of the things that we typically would like to look at. And then you're looking at employees with more than one cash outstanding advance. Again, an audit and compliance process, if you're looking at filtering some of these employees, it's very difficult to find out a random pick of those employees if you have to just pick up something for audit perspective or compliance perspective, where here the system is going to show you employees which are using more than one cash advance. If you have a policy or if you think that these are the employees who may be abusing the system, then that's where probably it gives you, again, information around who you want to target, whether you want to talk to their bosses and figure out why they are doing that. Expense trends, you can look at different expenses and the trends, so, you know, employee-wise or by category, by last year, current year, quarter, last quarter, month, week. So again, this gives you a pretty good way of whether an employee is really, suddenly you find an employee spending a lot of money, let's say, for example. Then whether that employee is consistently spending that money, as you can see here. So this gives you, again, a very good visibility into whether are there any employees who are consistently spending high, and if they, is it something that they usually do, they're required to do that in their job, or is it because somebody's just, one in a quarter you have found somebody spending $78,000 and then, okay, there's no other expense for these employees, so what happened? So those are the kind of things and questions. Again, from audit perspective, you're looking for these kind of anomalies. You can look at, you can pick up a dimension like by employee and look at now this information, and you can look at, I want to look at last year, current year, or whatever information, or I want to look at all of that. So this really gives you a very good way of looking at and targeting your employees, targeting your audit process, compliance process, and also look at are these genuine expenses that are being targeted here from employees. You're looking at top 10 spenders, employees-wise total expenses. You can drill down into these expenses. So I want to look at what Lee is spending. I just drill down into Lee and look at, okay, Lee is spending more on it, how many trips he's making and things like that. I can further select hotels and see which hotels typically he will. So you can drill down more and more as you want within this expense profile and try and understand what's going on within that expense. We also have an ad hoc report builder, so this gives you a very good way to build your own report or build your own pivot table or a straight table for analytics perspective. So you can select any of the columns or data fields that we have within the application. And I'm going to look at location. I'm going to look at month. I'm going to look at which vendor. I'm going to look at department. So when you do this and then you start analyzing the information, basically you're looking at triad. So these are different dimensions which you can categorize. So you're looking at employee data, report data, financial reporting data, approvals, credit cards, travel air, and you can have more categories if you want. And basically, you can look at this information, and then you can also select what's that you would like to see in terms of data information per se, and then basically build your own customized report, so to speak, of which you can analyze within the application again, or you can export it out to Excel, and basically again these are the different KPIs that you have. You have different etiquette related, violation related, transaction data, so approved amount, for example. I want to look at our cash advance amount if he has a credit card or charge card. So this now you're basically building a custom report, and instead of going back to IT department or trying to figure out manually all this information, you are now able to do this report or get this kind of data information within your system automatically. And not only just like that, you can also export this out to Excel, as I showed you earlier, or a PDF or email to somebody else if you want to send this data out. So now this gives you a complete, I would say, flexibility in terms of how you want to analyze, what kind of report you want to build, what kind of information that you want to share. So this becomes a very easy way for any user to analyze this information and really get what you want. So this is a big thing that's going to take a little bit here. But, the idea is that you can and this is an Excel that I just downloaded. So now, if we just look at this, so you got your entire report. 2015, so you have close to 1 million records. So idea was, again, to show that you can quickly do all of these within the application, and it still provides you a lot of information, a lot of insights, your top and bottom X in terms of employees, your categories, your spend, your region, your departments, and you can slide out, slide in, top 15, top 20. So again, you don't have to really remember what you want to do here. You can look at your bottom X, if you want to look at your bottoms in terms of where you're spending more or less and things like that. Again, you still have all your filters by company, so I want to select by a specific company or by a specific department within that company. I can do that. So we have about 15 more minutes now, so I would like to take a stop here and then open up the session for more question answers. So either you can type in your questions here, or you want to unmute yourself and talk. That's also. Any questions from anyone? Or you want to see something more, let me know.
Hi Milan, Jagan here. So I have one question. So do you integrate the P-card and travel agency data?
Yes, as I mentioned earlier, so we do integrate data coming from P-card. So you can have, you may be using a P-card or a corporate card from multiple banks. In that case, we can integrate data. We already have integration touch points with banks like Citi, JP Morgan Chase, Wells Fargo, MX, US Bank, and some of the large banks that we have in the US. So we should be able to get data from them. And also from a travel expense system perspective, we have integration with Concur and some of the leading systems available at the marketplace. So we can get data from the system.
Okay.
Any other questions, anyone?
Milan, I have one more question. So, on the T&E, you know, how do you measure the T&E cycle report time? So, how do you do that?
So, most of the time, if you're using a travel expense management system like Concur, for example, it allows you, it basically has data points where it says, when the report was created in the system, when the report was submitted for approval, and when the report is approved in the system, if you are having a workflow system within your travel expense management system, then it will tell you when the report was approved, and then when if the report was approved or if there is a question back and forth, then we also have those statuses. And once the report is approved, when the payment was actually made or the amount was sent to employees' account. So we look at all these different dates within the travel expense management system and calculate those cycle times.
Okay.
And that's typically measured against your benchmarks, as you said. You can look at your cycle times versus what you expect that your employee should do.
Okay. And Milan, you mentioned about these policy violations. So it is very important to get the employee details. So how do you integrate the employee designation and the hierarchy, which would be required, you know, for the calculation of these policy violations? So how do you integrate that?
Most of the time, we work with, we get the data from ERP systems. If you're using Oracle or SAP or PeopleSoft or JD Edwards, any of the Microsoft, any of the ERP systems available out in the marketplace, then you have those, that organization structure defined within your ERP system in terms of the employee information, their manager, their bosses, their department that they work with, and all that information. So typically we get data from that, but if you do not have a very well-defined organization structure within your ERP system, then you can also add an Excel sheet or some other app, other form of data which we can incorporate within the application from that perspective. And you can keep changing that data, because usually when we work, we get the HR data from ERP systems, we usually refresh that information once in a week, or we can do it on once in a day. It doesn't matter. It just, we need to make sure that information is refreshed to see you the latest employee hierarchy and organization within the system. Anyone, we have 10 more minutes. Just want to make sure that we have enough time for probably about 5 questions or so. And I also wanted to add that we do have some artifacts on our website. So if you go to easydatamunch.com, we have actually a few best practices white papers on travel expense. So if you go to the resources section on our website, and then if you go into the case studies, we have a case study, but we also have a white paper which talks about best practices in travel entertainment spend. So you want to probably definitely download this white paper and see the information that that we provided here in terms of what are typical areas from travel expense management and best practices perspective that you would like to inculcated in your organization. So there's a lot of information that is out there. So do visit our website as well and see the information that's out there that can be helpful to understand various things. So I have one more question here. How do you get compliance measurement in your analysis? That's a pretty good question. So there are two ways to get this information in our analysis here. So going back here, there are one way is to, if you're using some system where you may have defined some of these policies and compliance things, we do get that information in our system. But it can be a simple spreadsheet where you can define the KPI and say that this is my, let's say for example, you have a KPI for report should be submitted, and you can say 15 days is my earliest limit, but it should not be later than 21 days. So you say you can give us multiple benchmarks, you know, what's your acceptable and what's like the red flag kind of a thing where you definitely don't want an employee to submit reports after 21 days. So you can put that in a spreadsheet and you can have as many as benchmarks that you want to have. As long as we have the data pertaining to those benchmarks calculation, we will be able to calculate those benchmarks and provide you the analysis that you need from compliance and audit perspective, from violation perspective. So again, another question we have is, how do you correlate data from travel reporting systems? Are there only certain data fields that you use for audit and compliance? Now, this is again a pretty good question. So based on the travel management system, reporting system that you might be using, and Concur being one of the leading systems out there in the marketplace, I'll try and refer to this question, how do we do for Concur, and something similar that we do for a couple of other systems that we work with in the marketplace. So within the Concur, there are a couple of ways you can extract data. So you have an extract utility provided by within the system and build a report, basically data, some of the data fields that are out there, and you can extract that data and then uploading to our reporting platform. So that's one way which we are seeing customers utilizing our system, where you create a custom extract report within the report extract option that an administrator will have within your organization, and you basically create that report and extract the data and upload in the system. Now, the shortfall of that process is Concur will never allow you to extract each and every data field that they have within their data set. So usually you will be able to extract 50 fields or 60 fields from that extract process. But Concur per se, they have something called an SAE file that they provide you as an extract, or we have an API that fetches that file from Concur application that has 250 plus fields. So it's something that every organization can work with their Concur, or if you are having a customized in-house travel agency system, which can be based on a .NET application or any other similar platform, then we can directly connect to the database itself and bring every column that you have in the data field, database, and the tables that you may have. So it really depends upon what you have. We do not have any limitation in terms of how much data we can manage in our application. It can be 50 columns, it can be 500 columns. And we always recommend, from audit compliance or even analytics perspective, you should always get as much data as you can. Whether you're utilizing the data or not, that's a secondary issue, but you should get as much data first and then figure out how you utilize or what data is more relevant to what you're trying to do. Any more questions? We do have 5 more minutes, so we'll have time. Before we end the call, we will provide this video as a link on our website and also through an email for people who have registered and probably could not attend this webinar, and everybody who is on this webinar today. And again, if you have any questions, please do write to us. We'll be happy to talk about how we can help you improve your compliance and audit process and utilize data that you already have in your organization to do a better job and control the spend. We have seen organizations saving millions of dollars in this process. It would be very important for everybody to look at this information and see how they can really do something about it. So I'll wait for a couple of more minutes. Otherwise, really appreciate everybody's time this morning, and thank you for joining us. And I really hope that you, hopefully this will give you a good perspective in terms of what you can do with your trial expense data within your organization, how you can really improve compliance and audit, as well as analysis of what's going on within the trial and entertainment category as such, per se. And then hopefully this will allow help you to improve your process, your data compliances, and policy compliances within the organization. And we do have a lot of other webinars and other information out on our we do provide analysis around spend, other generic spend, other categories that you have. We also have analysis around labor costs or overtime, another similar scenarios, scheduling scenarios. So easy data months, so we have a portfolio of 150 all applications today that are utilized by companies across North America. And definitely you can subscribe to this applications. We also provide, as part of the people who attended this this webinar and who registered for it, you have an option to do a free pilot or a free trial. So if you want to use your data and of us to consider this application based on your own data set, we'll be happy to do that and provide you a free trial for you to explore and see if you like what you see and it helps you in your process. And if that's the case, then we can provide you this on a more subscription-based model as well. So thank you once again, and have a great day to everyone. And we look forward to joining you on our next webinar. Thank you.